Malicious actors are targeting Flipper Zero enthusiasts. Google Homes could spy on you and using ChatGPT for malware. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morse and this is ThreatWire for January 10th, 2023. This is your summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. Let's go ahead and jump right into the news this week, all about Flipper Zero. Now heads up for InfoSec folks and hackers, this one is for you, especially if you want a Flipper Zero. Now I just got to play with a Flipper Zero during CES and those things are seriously cool, but there's a new phishing campaign going around which targets these devices. Now, while the Flipper Zero has tons of tech built in like NFC cloning tools, a TV beacon, Bluetooth, RFID, and more, but due to supply chain shortages, custom enforcement, and payment platform issues, getting one actually in hand can be a very tough process. And due to this, malicious actors are targeting hackers by creating fake shops pretending to sell Flipper Zeros, a discovery made by security analyst Dominic Alvieri. Now, these fake sites have checkout pages which are used to phish victims. After a buyer inputs their email, their name, and shipping address, they can also purchase one with either Ethereum, Litecoin, or Bitcoin by sending the total cryptocurrency to a wallet. Now, as with any online shopping, this is not a new story. Be wary of third-party sellers, check and double-check the URL for the site that you are visiting and purchasing from, and only purchase products from reputable sellers. A researcher found an issue in the Google Home branded smart home speakers that could allow an attacker to listen to audio from the microphone. Specifically, a third party could add a new account to the Google Home and send commands to it via a cloud API. Now, researcher Matt Kuntz found the issue on his own Google Home mini speaker. He used an Nmap scan to find the local HTTP API port for the Google Home. Then he set up a proxy to capture HTTPS traffic. Now, Kuntz found that the device's name, certificate, and the cloud ID were required in order to create new users. This information would allow him to send a link request to the Google server, so he created a Python script to automate that process of grabbing the local device data and recreating those steps to get the link request. So if an attacker was not on the same Wi-Fi connection as the Google Home that they wanted to attack, they could listen to local Wi-Fi packets to look for a client matching Google's MAC address, which always starts with the same prefix, target the client and send DAuth packets to it to disconnect it from its local Wi-Fi connection, make it enter setup mode, then connect and request its local information, that being the name, the certificate, and the cloud ID. Then the attacker could use this device to link their own account and spy on the victim remotely. Now, Kuntz's blog explains the technical details, and he also published 3 proof of concepts on GitHub. If a rogue account is added to a Google Home speaker, not only could they just listen to the microphone, but it could also be used to control any connected smart home tech like cameras or switches. They could brute force pins used to lock doors and a lot more. An attacker could also set up a routine to call them and enable that speaker at any time. The researcher notified Google way back in January of 2021, and everything was patched by Google in April of 2021. The update blocks new accounts via a new invite-based feature, and if a Google Home is DAuth from a local Wi-Fi network, this no longer allows for new accounts to be added during that process. Google also added prevention techniques to stop remote call invitations. Kuntz was awarded over $100,000 for finding this vulnerability, props to him, and responsibly disclosing it to Google. If you own a Google Home, make sure that it is running the newest firmware, as these updates have been fully patched. Biggest of shout outs to my Hush Puppy Perk level patrons for sharing their fur baby photos and for the support. And a huge thank you to Joshua and, I feel like sometimes you just put names into Patreon to hear me say them, Thunder Beaver from the Freaks.club for being a part of the Alliance at patreon.com/ ThreatWire. Huge thank you to both of you. I appreciate you for signing up. And of course, if you want to join them, you can also join the Patreon as well. But this year, I will be migrating all of the perks and early access content over to my Morse code Patreon and combining the two Patreon accounts to make releases and perks for y'all more efficient, because I have been double posting to both of those over time. Now, you can get ahead of this change by moving your pledge over to patreon.com/Shannon Morse. You will still get all of the perks associated with this Patreon, with the added benefits of my Morse code perks for the same membership prices. So you're going to get more for one subscription. So let me know if you have any questions down below. My YouTube channel is youtube.com/Shannon Morse for everything from tech reviews to security tutorials. Last week I posted several videos from CES and I have a lot more on the way. Don't forget to like and subscribe to Hack 5 as well, but let's go ahead and finish out today's episode with my last top story, all about ChatGPT malware. Checkpoint researchers are diving deep into ChatGPT to see how this AI tool is being used to write malware. Now, OpenAI released ChatGPT to the world at the end of November 2022. It's a free natural language processing tool that can be used to generate human-sounding essays, emails, code, even things like poems have been generated using ChatGPT. And while OpenAI has clearly specified in their terms of service that using ChatGPT for generation of malware, defining this as ransomware, keyloggers, viruses, or other software intended to impose some level of harm and of spam, are banned on their platform. And that has not stopped some curious parties from using it for just that thing. Now, Checkpoint analyzed data from hacking forums showing that many users are already doing this, even with little or no previous knowledge of programming or development. I hate using the term script kiddie because I feel like everybody starts somewhere. Now, in one example, a user was able to use ChatGPT to create a Python-based info stealer, which searches for common file types and then uploads copies to an FTP server. Java-based malware was created as well, harnessing PowerShell to download and run other malware. Another user claimed that they were able to create their first script using ChatGPT ever, which could be used to encrypt and decrypt files. Now, it's not just Python and JavaScript either. Some users and researchers have been able to write fully automated workflows for attacks using convincing phishing emails. But I have a question for y'all. Does this mean that ChatGPT is bad? I think no, definitely not. Any advanced technology could be used for both positive purposes as well as nefarious ones, including many information security tools and software. In each of these cases, the code generated is fairly rudimentary, and it would require some adjustments to work efficiently, and ChatGPT has also been used to create defensive mechanisms for detection of malicious URLs or code. Now, since this is an AI tool, it could learn and create more advanced code over time, so watching these trends closely will be important to see how this changes the threat landscape. Now, this is such an interesting conversation. I really get a lot of love from being able to learn and educate myself about ChatGPT and AI being used for these kinds of things. So feel free to continue it down below if you want to be a part of that conversation. I'm Shannon Morse, and I will see you on the internet.